Hey guys, I'm going to teach you how to find the volume of rectangular prisms. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to use a formula to find the amount of space inside of a 3D object, which is the definition for volume. So go down and get your binder, turn to the math section, and get ready to take some notes. All right, let's start with the definition for volume, and then we'll review some other geometry words that lead us up to volume. So volume is the total capacity of a 3D object. It describes how much space the object occupies. Since we're talking about rectangular prisms today, let's go ahead and take a step back and review everything we know about rectangles and see how we can get to volume of rectangular prisms. So let's start with a basic rectangle. We know two words, perimeter and area. Perimeter is like the fence around your yard. It's all of the sides added up. And since we know that rectangles have two congruent sides, which you can see here shown by these two lines, and then the width with the one line, we can use a formula 2 times the width plus 2 times the length will give you the perimeter. And that's just in regular units since it's just the length around. Also, you can think about that like a picture frame. Other word we should know is area. Area is how much space is inside of a two-dimensional object. So if this was a yard, the perimeter is the fence, and the area is like the grass or the land in square footage. If it was a picture frame, the perimeter is the frame, and the area is the picture. We found area by using the formula length times width, or base times height. The difference between perimeter and area is that perimeter is just the length around, but area is a dimension that's length times width. So it's actually giving us the number of unit squares that would cover the surface of a 2D figure. So since units are squared, we use a little exponent of 2, which means units squared. Now a prism is a three-dimensional figure, which means that it's made up of two-dimensional flat surfaces, except now it has some depth. So instead of just having a length and a width, it also has a height. So area and surface area are different because the area of a figure is just the area of one two-dimensional side. Whereas surface area applies to three-dimensional figures. And in a rectangular prism, it's all of the areas of the sides added up. We could see that in a net and with that formula here. Length times height plus the width times the height plus the length times the width. And then multiply that by 2 since there's a front and a back. You can see that in the net here. There's a side and another side in the back you can't see. And there's a top and a bottom. When we're thinking about surface area, what I like to compare this to is like wrapping paper. How much wrapping paper can you wrap around the outside of this figure? But the question we haven't answered yet is how much we can fit into this box. That's where volume comes in. So the same way we think about area as square units, I like to think about volume as cubic units. If you look at this rectangular prism here, it's made up of cubes. It's 3 cubes or 3 cubic units tall, 5 units long, and 2 units wide. And volume is a lot like area, except it's for three-dimensional figures. We're basically trying to figure out how many cubes make up this rectangular prism, which is the definition of capacity. How much does it hold? If this was a fish tank, we would be thinking how much water can go into it. So that's what volume is. And the good thing about volume is that there's actually a really, really easy formula you can use to find the volume of a 3D object. And rectangular prisms are especially easy. Start figuring out that formula by starting by shading the bases of the rectangular prisms below. Take a second, pause the video, do that now, and press play when you're ready to check. All right, so that question is actually a little bit tricky when it comes to rectangular prisms, because usually when we talk about prisms, they're named after the shape that is their basis. For example, triangular prisms have 2 triangles as their basis. A rectangular prism, everything is a rectangle. So if there's not an area of the figure shaded, you can assume that it's what it's sitting on. So the top and the bottom is what I shaded for these. It doesn't matter what you picked, as long as you picked 2 sides that were parallel to each other. That's the key to finding bases of any prism. They're the 2 sides that are parallel to each other. The most important part of this is to figure out how can you find the area of the bases. Like we already reviewed, since all the bases are rectangles, the area can be found by using the formula area equals length times width, or base times height. Just to get down what we've already reviewed, the base of a 3D object names the shape, in this case, rectangular prisms. A prism has 2 bases which are parallel to each other and do not touch. All right, now pay attention because this is the key to the lesson. When we find the volume of any 3D figure, we can find that by finding the area of the base, which we use a capital B to denote on formula sheets, and then multiplying it by the height of the object. So what you'll see for volume of rectangular prisms, the formula will be capital B times the H. A capital B is not the same as a lowercase b. The lowercase b would be like the base, like a little b, like a length or a width. But the capital B means the area of the base. And since these two letters are next to each other, I know they're being multiplied. So I'm multiplying the area of the base times the height. This is why I love volume of rectangular prisms, because we know the area of a base, any of these bases, is just the length times the width. So the real formula for rectangular prisms volume It's just going to be the length times the width times the height. If you have three dimensions of a rectangular prism, just multiply all three of them together. And that's why I said it doesn't matter what you pick as your base for a rectangular prism, because if you picked this 4.5 by 9 rectangle as your base, then you would just need to use 6 centimeters as your height. The opposite is true. If you pick the bottom as the base, 6 centimeters by 9 centimeters, you would need to use the height of 4.5 centimeters. It doesn't matter in a rectangular prism which one uses the base because of the commutative property of multiplication. Order doesn't matter in multiplication as long as that's the only thing you're doing. So let's find the volume of the rectangular prism below. We're going to use this chart to guide our steps. Take a second and try this all by yourself and then press play when you're ready to check. All right, so the first step is to identify our formula. We can see this is a rectangular prism since it's a 3D shape made up of rectangles. The volume of any prism can be found by area of the base times the height. And since this is a rectangular prism, we can also use the formula. Volume equals length times width times height, where we've substituted length times width in for the area of the base. Now we need to plug in our values. It doesn't really matter the order that you've put these in. I'm using 6 and 9 as my base. So this is the area of the base times the height of 4.5. But again, it doesn't matter the order you put it in. And I use parentheses to put these next to each other. Any numbers that are next to each other in parentheses, it just means to multiply. That will give me a total volume of 243 centimeters. And then we want to make sure that since we're talking about volume of a 3D figure, we use a little 3. It means that this rectangular prism here is made up of 243 cubed centimeters. If we look at this example here, you can see a visual representation of how this rectangular prism is broken down into cubic units. So we found that because there's 5 by 3 by 2, in total, there'd be 30 cubic units here. So the same would be true here. If there was a cubic centimeter, there would be 243 of them filling up this box. Here's some practice problems for you. We know that we can find the area of the base using the formula base times height or length times width. So the volume of rectangular prisms we would find, finding the length, the width, and the height, and then just multiplying them all together. So take a second and try all 12 of these problems by yourself and press play when you're ready to check. All right, so take a second and pause the video again now that you see the answers. Check all of yours and just make sure that you put the cubed on all of your units. Since they're all in centimeters, they're all in cubic centimeters. And if you had any trouble with these, just let me know. Guys, that's it. If you made it to the end of this video, please put in the comments, what is your favorite rectangular prism? Mine is either a Pop-Tart box or a swimming pool. Today, we learned all about the volume of rectangular prisms. Now you should be able to use the formula area of the base times the height to find the amount of space inside of the 3D object, which is the volume. So now you should go back to the calendar and complete any of your assignments you have left for the day. I mean, if you have any questions, bye.